Cooking Tausho Buddhavi, cooking lovingly and meditatively. Your body is the temple. Treat your body gracefully and wisely. Tausho Buddha begins Know Your Food series to educate about flour, coconut oil, spices and all that you need to know about your food. Seeking your health with every product. A new Know Your
Wednesday morning time, my dear friends, exactly 10:30 a.m. Akashvani 106.5 FM. Music for the mind and the spirit, the number one East Indian radio station in Trinidad and Tobago. Performing is a presentation of Tausho Buddha, Know Your Foods, all claims made are those of the advertiser and not of the station. Welcome into the studios of Akashvani.
Good morning, listeners, on your favorite mid-morning radio program, Know Your Foods. I am Tausho Buddha, your presenter. All the listeners on Akashvani 106.5 FM and those who are listening via streaming on akashvaniradio.co.tt and those who listen to these on my YouTube channel, you are a welcome. We are coming to you with the compliments of Prem Singh's Puja Bhavan, 663-6084, Naipaul Extra Food, MS Food City Supermarket, 647-7993 in Debe, Price Club in Chaguanas, Cost Price in Lower Aranguez, and Hilo Food Stores. This is a program to educate you about various ingredients like whole wheat flour, gluten-free flour, Himalayan rock salt, coconut oil, Shri Gun blend of spices, and all that you need to know for a balanced and healthy living. We are coming to you with the compliments of Tausho Buddha Food Network, the suppliers of Swarna and Deep whole stone grind whole wheat flours, basmati rice, biryani pulao masala, samosa masala, and a wide range of deep frozen products. Deep samosas, the cocktail samosa, peas and potato samosa, spinach and paneer, chicken samosa, mixed vegetable samosa, chili paneer samosa. All these are available in packings of 12, 8, 24 and 36. Then we have garlic naan, plain tandoori naan, paneer paratha, aloo paratha. And next week you will have the Indian ice cream in malai faluda, tutti frutti and mango flavor. Then few other items. And soon we will be having the wide range of other items. Chicken vindaloo, ready to eat lamb vindaloo, chicken burgers, masala burger patties and many more items. Just remember these items. Remember, food is your fuel. Just as gas-dependent car splutters and comes to a stoppage if we pour cooking oil into the gas tank instead of premium gasoline. Our bodies get blockages and disease if we are not using the food of optimum quality. The Ayurveda sage says that food is our medicine. Eating the right food at the right time, two things are important, right food and right time. Not that whenever it is convenient you eat. Occasionally there may be a time when you cannot eat the food at the right time. But what happens, eventually your body develops a sense that this is the time the food comes in and it starts preparing itself. Just as the householder knows that 12 o'clock my son comes in, so the food is already on the dining table. Same way, your digestive system knows that and prepares for the process of digestion because food is coming now. But if you do not eat in time, then the digestion process has already started. The juices for digestion has already released in the body and they will create problems in the body. Today I will speak to you a little bit about the two spices, nutmeg and mace. These are two aromatic spices which are very, very important for the diets. But we in Trinidad does not use nutmeg too much except when we have to use for our ritualistic worships. We do not use know its qualities, its nutritional and the medicinal properties. Nutmeg and mace is the outer covering. It is a light brown covering that covers the nutmeg. Nutmeg is known in Hindi as jayfal. The oil is very important. It has many, many nutritional qualities and it is very good for nerves, digestion, blood flow and brain activities. The nutmeg oil, rubbing it a little bit on your temples is very useful, and then the nutmeg in the food is very important. Now all our spices, whether it is biryani pulao masala, and in fact biryani pulao masala is supposed to have more than 32 different spices. Probably some of these you have never heard the name. You know only one thing that we call curry powder in Trinidad, and that has the maybe the onion seeds, which is kalonji, turmeric, which we call wrongly as saffron in Trinidad, and then it have the coriander, maybe chili powder. But there are many aromatic spices which gives you a flavor and the aroma to the food. Just as when you are going, if a person is well dressed and have nicely perfumed and makeup, that person attracts your attention more than a person who is shabbily dressed, unless there is exception. Same way when you go to a restaurant, the ambience in the restaurant, the food's look, its aroma, that opens up your appetite. This is the reason that we use certain colors in the restaurant. The entire deco, the tablecloth, all are of different shades of red, and then gold is also used. So red color opens up your appetite. So in East Indian food, we must have the foods having the different shades of red as its final appearance. Then in between there is a streak of white. This is midnight beauty. Once I went to a restaurant and I asked what is the drinks, he said midnight beauty. Want to know, that time I was quite young and we used to try new items that were on the menu list. So I said, okay, get us midnight beauty. You know what it was? It was a glass full of soft drink Coke and ice cream into it. So the Coke is of a dark color and the ice cream is white color, so it is midnight beauty. The same way when you are the East Indian food, when you go to an East Indian restaurant, you have the vegetables, dals coming in very nice, with nice aroma. And not only aroma, the look is there. It is a different shade of, various shade of red color and a streak of white, which is fresh cream. So when you are eating the food, and it is number one, it has the protein, which is called beans. Then it has the milk. Do not get into the wrong idea that these foods are very rich and they increase the cholesterol level in your body. What increases the cholesterol level, the bad cholesterol, LDL, is the trans fat. And when you eat the trans fat or the empty calorie food, empty calorie food means what? Like potato is empty calorie. Sweet potato is time release. As the sugar level is needed in the body, it releases. And when you are eating empty food, which is the white sugar, white flour, it changes the insulin level in your blood and causes imbalance. So always choose the right product. When you are using the trans fat oils, the cheap oils, your shelves are decorated with in the supermarkets. When you use that, you use empty calories, then your LDL level goes up. And it does not matter how much tablets you take, your LDL level does not change. A couple years back, my LDL level was quite low, but HDL was also within the lower limits, not on the higher limits. Because in India, we accustomed putting the clarified butter on the smearing on the rotis, chapatis, and then eat. And then we cannot eat dal without adding a spoon of clarified butter or ghee. This is not the habit in Trinidad. I had to live in Rome and do as Romans do. Then my doctor told me, he said, you are from India, you are accustomed to using the clarified butter, which is ghee, cow ghee, increase the quantity of that. Your body needs 15 milliliter of good quality fat every day orally. Orally I mean like a tonic every day. This is why we take omega-3 fatty acid, whether it is flaxseed, the vegetarian, or fish. Omega-3 fatty acid, which is good for your brain cells. So he said, take that. So what I started doing, I started putting the ghee on my roti before I eat, and also I take a stick of coconut oil frozen and eat it first thing in the morning before breakfast. So my HDL level is very good now. There is no problem with that. And every cell in your body needs oil, needs lubrication. So it is a very wrong notion that you want to cut down on the fat. This is a cheap, empty propaganda which has been done by the manufacturers world over. So we have to be aware of it. These spices, the aromatic spices, form the part of the specific blend for a specific item. Like for instance, biryani, I was telling you, it requires 32 different spices, aromatic and the basic spices. So when everything is in proportion, be it pepper, be it the turmeric, be it coriander seeds or nutmeg, mace, cinnamon, the clove, black pepper, the cardamom, the red cardamom, which is a big elaichi, then bay leaf, all these form the part of biryani and many more spices. So when you use all these, it becomes very, very nutritious, and you do not need to add anything to it, pepper sauce or anything. And I can assure you, when if you eat food cooked by me, you don't have to add anything. No pepper sauce will be needed. And when it comes to cooking, soon I will inform you, we are going to start a cooking class, 8 weeks East Indian cooking class. The venue most likely will be Prisal Community Center. So I have to inform you where I will teach you all the different types of rotis, parathas, samosas, sweets, snacks, the gravies, and all these things will be taught in 8 weeks course. So probably 2 courses per week will be taking place, so that we can finish in 4 weeks time. So for all the further information, you can call 747-9770 Swami Anand Nilambar, or just remember Anand, or 683-8587 Taosho Buddha. You can call any one of these numbers and you get further information and updates on this. So when we use nutmeg, nutmeg forms the part of our garam masala. Garam masala, as the name goes, garam is hot, masala is spice. This contains only the aromatic spices. Nutmeg, mace is very fragrant. And if it is used in too much quantities, that can spoil the taste. So these have to be used in a pinch quantity. Nutmeg, mace, clove. Clove is used as a painkiller. If you have problem with your teeth, tooth decay or pain, using the clove oil or clove is very important. If you have bone injury, then using the clove tea helps in alleviating the pain. So it is very important. Cardamom is aphrodisiac, relaxing. Red cardamom, the black pepper, cumin seed, cinnamon, all these things are put together in a certain proportion to create a combination which is known as garam masala. So if you want to use ordinary vegetables, you just sprinkle a pinch over it and it will add flavors to your food. Remember, the flavors is not only a whim. It has medicinal quality behind it. And it is because of this, the Indian sages, masters, the Ayurvedas, they have emphasized on the use of a proper balanced meal where all these things are used. Nutmeg and mace is used in different ways and means in different countries. It's growing, use and everything. In Indonesia, there is a jam is made with nutmeg. It is made with mace. And then in other countries, it is used differently. In Indian cuisine, nutmeg is used in many sweet as well as savory dishes. Now, the culinary is such an important and a comprehensive science. Now, during the Mughal period, Mughals were very much interested in the cultural values, music, the architects, the buildings and food. Sometimes a person will invite you and he will offer the food. You think that this particular dish is a gravy. So you mix with your rice and eating it, then you realize it is a sweet dish. So they make the ambience in such a way that it becomes deceptive. That is the art of culinary they had been showing. In the East Indian gravy, we make one gravy called white gravy. This gravy is made with cashew nut paste, the onion, the boiled onion, nothing like a red coloring or anything that has its use. Now, in even the spices we use whole. So we just put it so that they leave their aroma. The whole chilies are used so that the aroma is left in that, and then you come back and that's it. So this is why it is very important. It has been used in Dutch cuisines. Nutmeg is quite popular. It is added to the vegetables like Brussels sprouts, cauliflower and string beans. So remember, these two spices are very important. And then I will just speak to you a little bit about the nutmeg oil. Nutmeg oil stimulates heart and circulation, activates mind and revives people from fainting spells. It helps in stimulating digestive system, fighting wind, nausea, chronic vomiting and diarrhea. It encourages appetite and avoids constipation and fights gallbladder stones. It is a tonic for reproductive system while regulating scanty periods, relieving frigidity and impotence. It can help birth by strengthening contractions. The oil has shown good anti-inflammatory actions, is successful in relieving pain, specifically muscular aches and pains as well as rheumatism. And then next week I will speak somewhat on this item more. The document Nutmeg and Mace is available on myscript.com document. By now you should be familiar with all my sites where these things are available for downloads free for you. Nutmeg and Mace. If you just log Nutmeg and Mace by Taosho Buddha or on my script document. But if you look into this program on YouTube, I will put all the sites and links so that it will be easier. But this program for today will be available on YouTube for tomorrow. So you can look into and make a note of those sites from where you can get the useful information free of cost for download. And some of my sites and documents are viewed in over 120 countries, and the viewership has crossed even 3,000 to 5,000 per item. It is very comprehensive information. Don't forget about the oils, whole wheat flour, stone grind, the fire salt. Although I have not spoken to you about this, every time I have to speak about something new so that you learn more. But do not forget the old lessons, the past, what I have spoken to you about the use of the stone grind whole wheat flour, which does not require anything to swell, just naturally good and hygienic. Add the water, knead to your consistency and make roti. Use coconut oil, which clears your heart arteries, maintains a good healthy balance in the body, and it does not create trans fats in your body or enhances the LDL levels in your body. The Himalayan rock salt, just now our engineer, the program engineer Kamal Ratan told me that a few days ago he had the spasm in his back, lower back. So he called his wife and asked her to bring a little bit of fire salt, and he said within 5 minutes that cramp disappeared. You can call him directly and confirm that. I am speaking to you when you are using the good quality oils in your car. The performance of your car enhances when you use your shortcut methods or cheap oils, or do not change the oil filters or gas filters at every change. Then you are responsible for the functioning of the car. I emphasize, your body is the temple. Treat it lovingly and wisely. Only then you can make it last longer and perform better. Rather than you are going the every morning your car starts, jump starts. So do not let your body do a jump start. Let it start smooth and continue smooth until the allotted time of your life. Now let me speak to you about the frozen items. These frozen items are very hygienic, scientifically, and very suggest you that their cleanliness is so immense that it is sometimes beyond our apprehension. And when I spoke to my supplier that the chicken samosa does not have the chicken halal demarcation, so I was told that the certification, they were waiting and the certification did not come, and they had the inventory printed 1 million boxes for one item, chicken samosa. 1 million boxes. Can you imagine 1 million boxes for one item? This is the company that I am dealing with, and this is the company whose products are available at your doorstep through the supermarkets, Hilo Foods, Extra Food, Prem Singh's Puja Bhavan and Price Club and many other supermarkets. Of course, in South area, you can get all these products at MS Food City Supermarket in Debe. The telephone number 647-7993. Hilo Westmorings got the delivery this morning. Cascade and the other stores, the delivery is going. So wide range of samosas, wide range of parathas and the naans. So paratha, you can just warm it up. Put a little butter if you choose to, or you can eat it with anything and it can be eaten just as it is. Somebody told me that the person takes the aloo paratha and paneer paratha at his tea time along with the tea. The paneer is cottage cheese. So when your paratha is filled with paneer, then you have not only consuming the carbohydrate, but you are consuming the good quality fat and also protein, which is paneer, is a very good quality concentrated protein. So these products, and then for your taste, there is Indian ice cream is totally different. It is called the kulfi, but because of the technical reasons, we have to convert that recipe into ice cream. So you will get malai faluda. Malai means cream of the milk. And the faluda, it is like noodles and made out of arrowroot. That is smeared with that, and it gives a very nice ambience and the taste to the ice cream. Then mango and tutti frutti, these are the flavors which will be available next week. And then in our continued efforts, you will get different types of chickens. Chicken vindaloo. Vindaloo is a kind of a recipe, and chicken is cooked in that way, succulent chicken. Then lamb vindaloo, the chicken masala, tikka masala, and many other products. So for this morning, only this much, and all these products, if you are interested in wholesale inquiries, give me a call 683 8587 or 747 9770. These products are available at Prem Singh's Puja Bhavan, 663-6084, Nepal Extra Food, Price Club, Hilo Supermarket, Hilo Food Stores, MS Food City in Debe, and soon it will be available to a grocery, to a supermarket near you. For any inquiry,